The Andaman and Nicobar Islands, with all its pristine beauty, appear like jades and emeralds floating in the Bay of Bengal. History says that Christianity started in these islands as early as 1690, when Father Agnello, a Portuguese Franciscan of Pegu Mission from South Burma, landed at Car Nicobar. Then, when the British set up a penal settlement in these islands in 1787, along with the British officers, Christianity once again set its foot in these islands. Then the Catholic population of these islands was a part of the Apostolic Vicariate of South Burma. But later on, the Catholic Mission of Ranchi started sending laborers to work in the forests of the Andamans and hence to cater to their spiritual needs. In 1947, on the recommendation of the Archbishop of Rangoon, the Holy See officially transferred the Andaman and Nicobar Islands from the jurisdiction of the Archbishop of Rangoon to that of Ranchi. In 1964, on the recommendation of the Archbishop of Ranchi, the Mission of Andaman and Nicobar was officially handed over to the Society of St. Francis Xavier, Goa, by the Holy See. Two pioneers of the Pilar Society, Father Marian Dias, SFX, and Father Tabuccio Ferron, SFX, arrived at Port Blair on December 15, 1965 and took charge of the Andaman Mission with only one parish. With missionary zeal, the Pilar Fathers worked in dire conditions to unite the Catholic populace who were scattered in these far-stretched islands and also opened more parishes. On 30 December 1971, a young priest from Goa, Father Alex Dias, SFX, landed at Port Blair. He was appointed as the parish priest of Mayabandar Parish, a far-flung area, and he accepted his duties cheerfully. He was very lean and thin, but was very energetic. One could see him in his jeans and playing the guitar during the evenings and teaching songs to the children of his parish. His cherubic smile was a godly gift and he worked enthusiastically. He tried to connect the people of his parish who were scattered from Diglipur to Paransala in Rangat. He trudged the dilapidated roads and crossed the terrains and hills in rain, thunder or sunshine to meet his people. He attended meetings with the people in interior communities that would go on throughout the night for 15 to 16 hours to solve the problems of his parishioners. The bloodsucker leeches and poisonous centipedes and snakes would not impede his determination. Sometimes he felt lonely, thinking of his home and folks. He worked for 5 years and strived hard to uplift his parish. He was instrumental in starting the Prakash Vidyalaya and a home science school in Mayabandar. In 1976, Father Alex Dias was sent to Rome for higher studies and he thought that his mission work in Andaman was over. But God had other plans. On 18th August 1984, His Holiness Pope John Paul II, by a bull, Ex Cuo Christus, elevated the Andaman and Nicobar mission to a diocese, the Diocese of Port Blair, and Father Alex Dias, SFX, was selected by the Holy Father to be the first bishop of these islands. It was a moment of great joy and celebration for the people of Mayabandar Parish as their beloved priest had become the Bishop of Port Blair Diocese. Bishop Alex accepted the task reluctantly, but once he took up the charge, there was no looking back for him. Contemplating on God's plans, Bishop Alex says,
"Never in my wildest dreams did I think that I would be called to become a bishop of this diocese. This was really too much, and I tried my best to wriggle out of that situation when the call came. I do realize that one cannot wrestle with the Lord and hope to win. He had his own way and he won."
The people of Andaman and Nicobar Islands were very happy as they had got a bishop who would be their shepherd, a shepherd of the Green Islands who would nurture their spiritual needs. It was a time of jubilation, festivity, and prayers for all. The auspicious episcopal consecration ceremony was held by Archbishop Most Reverend Pius Kerketta of the Ranchi Archdiocese on 20th January 1985 with great fanfare in the Catholic Church ground, and Bishop Alex Dias accepted his crosier and mitre with his motto, "His power in my weakness." The whole communities of Catholics of these islands flocked in jubilation and thankfulness to participate in the episcopal consecration of their new bishop, Right Reverend Alex Dias SFX. 12 bishops, many priests and sisters came from mainland to join in the celebration. Bishop Alex Dias was born on 5th August 1944 to parents Francisco Xavier Dias and Feliza Clara Dias as the youngest child among five children in the family. He went to Little Flower of Jesus High School, Calangute. In 1956, he joined the All India Mission Seminary, Pilar, Goa, at the age of 11 years. In 1961, he joined the Missionary Society of St. Francis Xavier, Pilar, Goa, as a novice, and in 1962, took the first religious vow. It was a great moment for his family when he was ordained as a priest on 21st December 1969. After working for 5 years in the Andaman Mission, he was sent to Rome for higher studies. In 1976, he completed master's degree in sociology from Rome, and in 1980, he did a diploma in communications from London. From 1980 to 1984, he worked as the rector of Pilar Seminary, Goa. Bishop Alex strongly believes that his 5 years as a young priest in Mayabandar was a part of God's plan to prepare him for a tough life ahead as a bishop of a newborn diocese. He had been made the bishop of a diocese, and practically he had to begin from scratch. He was the youngest bishop with an infant diocese in his arms, with very limited financial resources, 4 parishes and only 15 priests in the whole diocese, and none of whom belonged to the diocese, and the diocese spreading over a distance of 700 kilometers from North Andaman to Campbell Bay Island. It was a colossal task for the new bishop. Bishop Alex has built up the Diocese of Port Blair brick by brick with his personal care and efforts. Just like a gardener tends his saplings, he too has nurtured his diocese, and today it stands strong and tall. Bishop Alex has used all his language skills, caliber and talent, and had gone from country to collect donations to fortify his diocese. After making hectic trips to benefactors abroad, he has been able to build churches and institutions. He has strengthened the diocese by forming small Christian communities, stressed on family prayers, and formed various organizations to streamline the youth and the lay faithful. Dear Bishop, you have strived hard to build up the lay leadership through various church associations of the diocese, like Catholic associations, Catholic Sabha, Mahila Sangh, Youth Movement, and Legion of Mary. You have attended to the needs of the linguistic groups of the diocese. You have given top priority to strengthen the faith of families through family prayer and small Christian communities. In every pastoral visit, you have stressed on this and strengthened the Catholic population spiritually. During one of your pastoral visits to Nicobar Group of Islands, at Car Nicobar, once you had to jump onto the pontoon from the raised gangway of the ship, and this gave you a severe backache and remained as a thorn in your flesh. In spite of the backache, you have maintained your tour diary punctually and with great fortitude. It was a fateful day on the 26th of December 2004 when the Andaman and Nicobar Islands were shaken by a powerful earthquake which measured 9.3 at the Richter scale, leading to disastrous tsunamis. Many people in the Nicobar group of islands had perished, and many of the structures of the Catholic Church, such as churches, convents, schools, rectories, had been wiped out by the mighty waves. Though Bishop Alex was deeply troubled and desperate within, but he did not give up. He personally visited all the churches in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands to see the conditions over there. A relief camp had also been set up at Nirmala School, and about 2,500 victims had been accommodated at Catholic Church grounds. Every day, like the morning sunshine, Bishop Alex Dias would come to the camp regularly to see the relief work going on and to motivate everyone. Many days, he used to stay there till late evening, very concerned about the victims and discussing about various actions to be taken for their welfare. He is a person with great compassion and is always ready to help the needy and the poor. Dear Bishop, the tsunami waves could not deter your determination. As you often say, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. You went tough with the tsunami, and all the churches, convents, schools and rectories were built only because of your strong determination. You went around the world and found benefactors to accomplish the work within a record time. The social service wing of the Catholic Church, Akani, was started by you, and many rehabilitation works had been undertaken under your guidance, such as construction of temporary and permanent shelters for displaced people and the establishment of self-help groups for the upliftment of the poor people, which was highly appreciated by the Andaman and Nicobar administration. The Dias family is indeed very proud of their youngest child, Bishop Alex Dias. Reginaldo, Bishop Alex's eldest brother, says,
"My brother Alex remains the most precious gem of the Dias household. I can say very proudly that not once in my whole life did my brother ever answer back or say something rude to me. He definitely could be a role model for all the brothers in the world. I pray that the good Lord showers Alex with his choicest blessings. Viva Aleixo!"
Sister Zita, Bishop's elder sister, says, "I have many, many nice things to say, but do not know where to begin and where to end. We call Alex Baba, and Alex wanted everyone to call him Baba Aleixo. If anyone called him Aleixo without the prefix Baba, he would tell them point blank, 'My name is Baba Aleixo.' My parents made great sacrifice to send Alex to the seminary at such a tender age. I wish Alex good health and God's grace in the years to come." Sister Jemma, Bishop's elder sister, says, "My brother Alex was my pride and love. I used to take great pleasure in boasting to my neighbors of how cute and chubby my brother was. I still remember the anger and pain I went through whenever his teacher punished him. I asked the Lord to shower his bountiful blessings and graces upon him and bless him abundantly." Greta, Bishop's niece, is very proud of her uncle Alex. She says, "It's amazing to see the love, affection and unity between Uncle Alex and his brother and sisters." Edwin, Bishop's nephew, has all praises for his Uncle Alex. He says,
"Uncle Aleixo has always been a dashing personality, and such is his charisma. He has always been a great lover of music, and his passion still continues till this day. Over the years, with his hair graying with the age and accompanying aches and pains, he still continues to be a source of inspiration to all of us. Long live Uncle Aleixo."
Along with the members of the Dias family, we, the people of the Diocese of Port Blair, are very proud of you, dear Bishop. You are an epitome of a faithful servant and of the existence of angels and Christ among us. Your faith is evident in all you do, and you set a wonderful example for us as how to live our lives here on earth. Dear Bishop, you are a person with charismatic personality. You have great passion for music, singing, reading and traveling. You are a great linguist and eloquently you speak 8 languages: Konkani, English, Hindi, Sadri, Portuguese, Latin, German and Italian. You are a great orator and can mesmerize the people with your beautiful words. There is always a divine smile on your face that attracts people to you. The people of Port Blair Diocese celebrated the Silver Jubilee of their beloved bishop and that of the Diocese of Port Blair on 20th January 2010 with great fanfare, prayers and celebrations. Our lives are enriched and deepened through your devotion to the church and your reverent celebration of the sacraments and the Eucharist that you demonstrate to the parishioners by your love for the church and Jesus Christ. You are a shining example for God's love to us. You take to heart the joys, sorrows, hopes, fears, triumphs and defeats of your flock through prayer and blessings. You know your people and exhibit pastoral charity that is essential to priestly credibility. You have worked lovingly with the highly educated to the poorly educated and unskilled volunteers. You empower them to see beyond their parish boundaries to the betterment of the community and our faith. You have done this through your interpersonal skills that convey your vision that allows you to remain grounded to the lives of people and your own humanity. You have met great personalities in your life, but you have always remained humble in all your deeds. You are a person with such simplicity and modesty. Your requirements and needs are very few. You walk with humility, upholding dignity. You never forget to acknowledge gratitude for even little assistance received. Port Blair Diocese would ever remain grateful for all the services you have rendered for its growth. Dear Bishop, you have accomplished the task assigned to you gracefully and with great faith. During pastoral visits, you have been striding long distances into the terrains of the rainforests that are infested with dangerous creatures, climbing up and down the hills, meeting people in interior places. You have united the Catholics of Andaman and Nicobar Islands into one diocese. Today, because of your great efforts, the Diocese of Port Blair has its own 23 diocesan priests and one deacon. There are also 22 religious priests and 100 sisters working in the diocese. Various missions such as socio-pastoral ministry, health ministry and education ministry are successfully being carried out by the diocese under your able guidance. The Diocese of Port Blair has grown today from 5 parishes to 16 parishes with 152 substations because of your hard work. You have gifted us a beautiful shrine at Panigat, expressing your deepest love for Mother Mary. Port Blair Diocese is grief-stricken today as our beloved Bishop Alex Dias is returning from Andaman. We would all like to wish you, our beloved Bishop, a very happy retirement that you have always hoped for. We know, dear Bishop, that your health is a reason which made you to take this decision. Our prayers are always with you and we believe that though you are going back to your hometown, your thoughts and prayers would always be with us, the Diocese of Port Blair. We fall short of words to express our gratitude for your selfless service all these 39 years. The gates of the Diocese of Port Blair remain open for you always and you're always welcome here. Viva la, our beloved Bishop Alex Dias. May God bless you always.